Good morning, 8th class, and welcome back to your social science class. In the last video, we talked about education under the British rule. So, how was the education under the British rule, in which we discussed about education in pre-India and education at the time of Britishers? We talked about in education in pre-British India, there were Pathshalas. What were their students? They were Pathshalas, and the Pathshalas followed a flexible system of education. So, also we talked about education under East India Company, in which we talked about the establishment of educational institutions. So students, in the previous video, हमने बात की थी कि जब in pre-British India, there were Pathshalas which followed a simple flexible system. Students used to sit on ground and they used to study. But in education under East India Company, there were the establishment of educational institutions like colleges, universities, and for example, the Hindu College, which was set up at Banaras. So we also talked about the Committee of Public Instruction, which encouraged the study of Sanskrit language. So this much we had discussed in our previous video. So, in today's video, we will talk about the two schools of thought. So, the two schools of thoughts are Orientalists and Anglicists. So, these are the two schools of thought. There were two groups of people. Some were Orientalists and the others were Anglicists. So, in this video, we will talk about who were Orientalists and who were Anglicists. The Orientalists were the people who had sound knowledge of the language and culture of Asia. So these people, the Orientalists, they had proper knowledge of Asian countries and also the culture of Asia. Students, you know, India lies in the Asian continent. So, these people were favoring the development of Sanskrit and Persian languages in India. So, they wanted that we should develop Sanskrit language, which was the original language of India, and also the Persian language. They also wanted the medium of instruction to be in these languages. So, these languages should be taught at school and should be the medium of instruction. So other studies should also be in Sanskrit and Persian. They wanted to set up such educational institutions that encourage the study of ancient Indian text. So they also wanted that more and more people should study the Indian text, the original, the history of India, the Indian text like the Veds and the other books, more and more people should be able to read them. The Orientalists had respect for the ancient culture of India and wanted to revive the same. So they wanted that the Indian culture should be adopted, promoted and followed. So they were favoring the Indian culture and Indian languages. Now, let us move ahead. There was also a political motive behind the encouragement of Sanskrit and Persian languages. So now we will study ki politically what was the motive that more and more people should study these languages. So, the political motive behind the encouragement of Sanskrit and Persian language was that if people will study these type of the Indian languages, Sanskrit and Persian, they will be able to help the company people to connect with the administration and judiciary. So they wanted more and more people should study the original language of India. Also, the ancient Indian text on administration, laws, rules of revenue, etc. were either in Sanskrit or Persian. So, even all the documentation was in these languages, Sanskrit and Persian. For a better understanding of India's past, its culture, rules, laws, tradition, and customs, the company officials required persons who could communicate these to them in simple terms. So they also want to study about India's history, what was the culture of India, and also the traditional and culture customs of India. So they wanted more and more people should study Sanskrit and Persian language so that the Indian culture should be promoted. Now, there are two examples of people who were Orientalist. The first example is of a person named William Jones. So, William Jones was a hardcore Orientalist. He was well versed in Greek, Latin, French, English, Arabic, and Persian. So, he knew so many languages. When he came to India in 1783, he joined the company of Hindu Pandits and learned Sanskrit language. But this person also, William Jones, he wanted that Indian languages, the Asian languages, the Asian culture should be promoted. And so, he also started learning Sanskrit language, grammar and poetry. So, now let's move on to another example, which is he was soon joined by Henry Thomas Colebrook and Nathaniel Halhed. So he was joined by two more people. The picture is given of Henry Thomas Colebrook and Nathaniel Prasse Halhed, who were also interested in Indian text. So they also wanted to study the original, the historical text of India. They together translated many Sanskrit and Persian texts into English. So they were translating. They were translating from Sanskrit to in English. Set up Asiatic Society of Bengal and started a journal, Asiatic Researches. So they were promoting, these two people were also promoting Sanskrit language. They were studying about Sanskrit language. So that's all about Orientalist. In more simple words, student, Orientalist जो लोग थे, वो ये चाहते थे कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा development हो Sanskrit and Persian language का. Also, they wanted कि जो Asian culture है, that should be promoted, उसका promotion हो. And also, they were also studying Sanskrit language because They thought about कि अगर वो इंडिया की customs, traditions and other things, history जानना चाहते हैं तो उनको Indian languages which is Sanskrit and Persian वो सीखनी पड़ेगी. So this was the view of Orientalist. Now we will study about Anglicist. So there was another group of people who used to call them the Anglicist. The Orientalist were opposed. Opposed matlab that they were not supported by Anglicist in the early 19th century. The Anglicist emphasized upon English language. Ab yahan par difference aa gaya ki Orientalist jo the wo to Sanskrit aur Persian language ko bol rahe the, but Anglicist chahte the promotion of English language to be the medium of instruction. कि बच्चों को schools में जो भी medium है instruction का, जो भी पढ़ाया जाए, तो वो English language में पढ़ाया जाए. They regarded the knowledge of East as unscientific. Eastern knowledge means the knowledge of Asian countries और वो इस सबको अनसाइंटिफिक मानते थे बिकॉज दे थॉट दैट पीपल हियर वर नॉट हैविंग साइंटिफिक टेम्परामेंट. दैट मीन्स दैट दीज पीपल डू नॉट थिंक साइंटिफिकली, मोर प्रैक्टिकली, एंड द लिटरेचर ऑफ ईस्ट एज लाइट हार्टेड, दैट वी आर हैविंग लाइट हार्ट्स. सो नाउ हियर कम्स द मेजर डिफरेंस कि ओरिएंटलिस्ट चाहते थे कि संस्कृत और पर्शियन लैंग्वेज का प्रमोशन हो और एंग्लिसिस्ट इंग्लिश को ज्यादा फोकस देते थे. सो ऑब्वियसली व्हेन देयर आर टू ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल, पीपल विल डिवाइड. सो नाउ वी विल स्टडी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एंग्लिसिस्ट पर्सन. James Mill and Thomas Babington Macaulay were the main supporters of English as well as scientific knowledge. So they wanted ki science ka promotion ho aur English ka promotion ho. They wanted to acquaint the Indians with the advancement of science and technology blooming in the West. So in Western countries already technology has arrived. People were becoming more and more scientifically connected. So they wanted ki jo technology hai aur science hai wo bhi India mein bhi aaye. So they wanted to, the medium of instruction should be English. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, now this person Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he was a reformer of India. So he also advocated, means supported the imparting of Western education through English medium. So he also imparted that English medium should be used to impart education. So now two group of people have different opinion. So now what happened was, this is very important, the next subtopic which we are going to study is Macaulay Minute of 2 February 1835. This is very important, student. I already told you above here that Thomas Babington Macaulay, he was a supporter of Anglicist. So now what happened was, when Macaulay was appointed as the chairman of the committee of public instruction. So there was a committee, public instruction, jo humne yahan par this page par we talked about the public instruction committee, which were giving grants, that means the funds. So uska jo chairman tha, the chairman was appointed, who was appointed the chairman as chairman? Macaulay. This person, Thomas Babington Macaulay, he was appointed as the chairman of this committee. So he emphasized upon the need to teach in English medium. So he has this only that English medium should be used to teach students. He laid stress on Western literature and sciences to be important subjects of study for all Indians. So he wanted that Western literature, science, ye sab include hona chahiye aur ye sab padhaya jana chahiye, English padhai jani chahiye. So he was of this viewpoint. The Macaulay Minute of 2 February 1835 means there was some meeting held on this date, 2 February 1835. The Minute means the major point of that meeting, the record of that meeting was clearly laid down that the, underline this student, the sole aim of the British would be the promotion of Western literature and sciences among the Indians. So very clearly it was laid upon that they were Britishers, they were British people, so they will be promoting their language, that is English, and they will also be promoting Western literature and science. Henceforth, all educational funds were to be spent on English education. So now whatever grants, whatever funds are given, they will be spent upon English education. Efforts were also made to stop the promotion of Calcutta Madrasas and the Banaras Sanskrit College, which favored Oriental learning. So some efforts, some people were also putting efforts that जो कलकत्ता का मदरसा है एंड बनारस संस्कृत कॉलेज है उसका भी जो फंडिंग है दैट शुड बी स्टॉप्ड बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट प्रमोटिंग इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. सो आफ्टर दिस मीटिंग ऑफ सॉरी आफ्टर दिस मैकॉले माइन्यूट ऑफ 2 February 1835 इट वॉज वेरी मच क्लियरली लेड डाउन दैट द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट विल बी सोलली एम्फसाइजिंग ऑन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. So now, another important fact which comes upon after 1835. So this was of 1835. Now we will be talking about 1854. After around 20 years, yes. So this is Charles Wood's dispatch of 1854. This is also very important. This is about Charles Wood. So now, students, we will talk about Charles Wood's dispatch of 1854. In 1854, Charles Wood, the president of the Board of Control, formulated a scheme for future education in India. So, Charles Wood, he formulated a scheme of education. It meant to provide a coordinated system of education on an all India basis. So the scheme will be operated in all India. This scheme came to be known as Wood's Dispatch. So isi scheme ka naam pad gaya Wood's Dispatch. Now we will be discussing about Wood's Dispatch, what it was and what it talks about. So students, the main recommendation of the Wood's Dispatch were as follows. First, teaching of Western education would be the aim of government education policy. So, government would be aiming to teach Western education, westernized form of education, that means Western literature, English language. Medium of instruction, so whatever medium would be in schools, and sorry, not in schools, in higher classes. So in schools, not at primary level, but at higher level. B, in English language. So in higher classes, it would be English language. Made provisions for setting up vernacular. Vernacular means the local language, jo wahan ke locally log bol rahe the, be it Hindi, be it any other language. Primary schools in villages. So in villages, at primary schools, only local language will be used. But after that, when the child goes to higher classes, English language would be used. Anglo vernacular high schools and affiliated colleges at the district level. So they also aim to set up high schools. That means for 9, 10th, 11, 12th, and at the district level, there will be also colleges. So there would be more opportunities for students to study further. Grants in aid were to be provided to encourage education. So they will also be providing funds, the grants, so that more and more students would be encouraged to study. Okay. Now moving further, it says a department of public instruction was to review the progress of education in the provinces. So in provinces, the education will also be reviewed, means they will keep a check also on how much progress education is being made. Made provisions for setting up universities at Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. So they will also be setting up universities. Stress was laid on the establishment of vocational and technical schools and colleges. तो सिर्फ academic पढ़ाई ही नहीं कराई जाएगी, मतलब vocational and technical schools. Vocational means जहां पर skill based knowledge कराई जाती है, कि skills सिखाए जाते हैं, beat computers or any other skill. And technical schools also, the technological knowledge also that would also be taught to students. Recommended establishment of teacher training institution. So there will be also institute who would be training teachers कि वो और बेटर पढ़ा सकें और इंग्लिश मीडियम में पढ़ा सकें, तो इसके लिए टीचर्स को भी ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी. सपोर्टेड द कॉज ऑफ एजुकेटिंग वुमेन. सो दे वर ऑल्सो सपोर्टिंग द कॉज दैट वुमेन शुड ऑल्सो बी एजुकेटेड. सो नाउ इट हैज दीज मेजर पॉइंट्स. सो विद दीज पॉइंट्स वी कैन से बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स एम्फसिस ऑन एवरी फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन. सो हर फील्ड पर ही जो है फोकस किया जा रहा था. दैट्स वाई द वुड्स डिस्पैच केम टू बी नोन एज द मैग्ना कार्टा ऑफ इंग्लिश एजुकेशन. ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि वुड्स डिस्पैच का ही सेकेंड नेम पड़ा मैग्ना कार्टा ऑफ इंग्लिश एजुकेशन. नाउ मैग्ना कार्टा स्टूडेंट्स इट इज अ ग्रेट चार्टर इन हिस्ट्री विच गारंटीज द राइट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल. तो ये फर्स्ट चार्टर था जिसमें राइट्स दिए गए थे पीपल को, इंडिविजुअल्स को. दैट्स वाई तो इसमें अगर हम देखें तो इंग्लिश एजुकेशन का ये मैग्ना कार्टा है बिकॉज नाउ पीपल हैव द राइट दैट दे कैन स्टडी इन इंग्लिश मीडियम बिकॉज द गवर्नमेंट द ब्रिटिशर्स दे वर फोकसिंग ऑन इट. बेस्ड ऑन इट्स रिकमेंडेशन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक इंस्ट्रक्शन वॉज सेटअप. So a new department was set up in 1855. The universities of Bombay, Madras and Calcutta, ye bhi kaha gaya tha upar ki universities ko set karna hai, so these were also set up in 1857. Some schools were set up for girls and were given grant in aids means funds to foster modern education. Ki modern padhai bhi ho sake aur girls ko bhi padhaya jaye, iske liye bhi funds jo hain diye gaye. So in short, जो education में revolution आया, it came with this act like the Woods Dispatch. It came with the recommendation of the Woods Dispatch, and that's why students, Woods Dispatch is also known as the Magna Carta of English education. But now we will talk about the practical benefits of the dispatch. कि प्रैक्टिकली उसके क्या बेनिफिट्स थे. ये वाले जो हमने बेनिफिट्स, ये जो हमने पढ़ी, ये रिकमेंडेशंस थी कि ऐसा करना चाहिए, ऐसा करना चाहिए, ऐसा करना चाहिए. बट नाउ वी विल सी कि उसका बेनिफिट क्या था. अपार्ट फ्रॉम मेकिंग प्रोविजंस फॉर एजुकेशन ऑन ऑल इंडिया बेसिस, सबसे पहली बात तो ये ऑल इंडिया बेसिस पे था, मतलब दीज रिकमेंडेशंस विल बी फॉलोड ऑल ओवर इंडिया. The Woods Dispatch also served the practical purpose of the company officials. So it was not only supporting Indian people, but practically देखा जाए तो ये company की भी मदद कर रहा था. Which company? East India Company. Those official people were also being helped. सबसे first reason है economic benefits. It was said that European learning would make Indians realize the importance of trade and commerce. So now when Indian people would be educated in European learning, means European learning means the Western education में जब पढ़ाया जाएगा उन्हें Indian लोगों को, तो वो trade और commerce जो business है उसकी भी समझ उनमें ज़्यादा, it will be more developed. Thus they would help in the development of the country's resources. So more resources means more money generating people will be there. By adopting the European ways of living, the taste and desire of Indians would gradually change. Now, they also had this viewpoint that when they would be studying in European language, so even their thinking would be in European language only. They will demand European clothes and luxury items. So they will also start slowly asking for that they want to become like European people. So they will ask for expensive clothes, expensive other items. This would further increase the sale of European goods in Indian market. So then the European goods will, their sale will increase. So they had this प्लान सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग इन देयर माइंड कि जब लोगों को यूरोपियन लैंग्वेजेस में यूरोपियन लर्निंग दी जाएगी, वेस्टर्न एजुकेशन पढ़ाई जाएगी, तो दे विल ऑल्सो स्टार्ट बींग वेस्टर्नाइज्ड, तो उन्हें भी जो उनकी नीड्स हैं वो चेंज हो जाएंगी. नाउ दे विल बी रिक्वायरिंग डिफरेंट क्लोथ्स, मीन्स यूरोपियन क्लोथ्स एंड लग्जरी आइटम्स. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द सेकेंड पॉइंट विच सेज It was said that the European ways of learning would inculcate moral values among the Indian. Yes, they would also be developed morally. It would make them honest and truthful and thus serve the political benefits of the company. The company could trust and rely upon honest Indian. तो जब इंडियन लोगों को अच्छे से दे थॉट कि यूरोपियन लर्निंग दी जाएगी, यूरोपियन कल्चर समझाया जाएगा, यूरोपियन एजुकेशन मिलेगी, सो वट विल बी हैपनिंग इज दैट दे विल ऑल्सो बी डेवलपिंग मोर इन मोरल वैल्यूज. एंड सो जब वो ऐसे मोरली डेवलप्ड एजुकेटेड पीपल हो जाएंगे, देन कंपनी ऑफिशियल्स विल हायर देम टू मेक देम वर्क अंडर देम. नाउ द थर्ड पॉइंट, दैट्स द लास्ट पॉइंट, European learning would instill in people a sense of desire and commitment towards their duties. Thus, so they also had this viewpoint that when European learning would be given to people, they will have a sense of desire and commitment. कि इन्हीं लोगों ने हमें जो है education दी है, so we will be more committed toward European people. So, thus, The company would get officers who were Indian by origin, just underline this point students, Indian by origin but European in their thoughts, working methods and skill. So, in the last they thought about ki jo log honge, agar unhe European learning di jayegi, European education, Western education and English language mein padhaya jayega, तो वो होंगे तो इंग्लिश सॉरी इंडियन ओरिजिन के, मींस देयर बर्थ वुड बी ओनली इन इंडिया, बट उनकी थिंकिंग जो है वो चेंज हो जाएगी, दे वुड बी थिंकिंग मोर इन यूरोपियन वे. सो दिस वाज द प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द डिस्पैच, वुड्स डिस्पैच. सो दीज वर द थ्री प्रैक्टिकल बेनिफिट्स ऑफ द डिस्पैच. सो स्टूडेंट्स, That's all for this video. What you have to do is that students, you need to read page number 87 and 88. You need to go through these two pages. And if you are having any doubt, then you can message me. So that's all students. Thanks and take care.